Senator Laura Thielen.
Aloha, good evening. My name is Laura Thielen. I'm a state senator for Kailua, Wamealo, and Hawaii Kai. I'm here tonight because I understand the aquifer these tanks sit above provides a quarter of the drinking water for the urban Honolulu area, which includes Samoa to Hawaii Kai. But I'm also here as a Windward resident because if that aquifer is contaminated, the Board of Water Supply is not going to have any option but to start to draw from other aquifers around the island. That's going to overpump and impact the aquifers on every area of our island. It's also going to impact our streams because some users are going to be forced onto stream waters. And so many of the battles that were fought to return waters from the streams to our nearshore waters to restore the riparian environments and the nearshore ocean blue rise are going to be impacted as well. I'm here tonight to ask you to reject the proposed AOC and to go back to the table to renegotiate it. The reason is this. These tanks are already 72 to 75 years old. If you're going to spend the next 25 years upgrading them, that means you plan to continue using them beyond that. The tanks will be 100 years old at the end of the time period of this AOC. Now, according to the Navy documents, and this was presented to the legislature in the task force report, the Navy's a member of the task force, these tanks have been leaking since 1947. The Department of Health was not made aware of that until 1998. The Navy is unable to quantify the amount of fuel that was released into the environment prior to that period. In 1998, they did core samples and found that there's petroleum leaks under 19 of the 20 tanks in the basalt rock. And they found that the groundwater monitoring wells that are near tank 5 and 6 have petroleum in 12 to 20 times the rate of the DOH acceptable level. Now the Navy said, don't worry, because what we're going to do is we're going to adopt the highest standard for tank inspections and repairs and maintenance. Well, guess what? Tank 5 had just finished that highest standard of tank repairs and maintenance and inspections that was supposed to ensure that it was operable for the next 20 years. And when they refilled it, it didn't last 20 days. It released 27,000 gallons of fuel into the environment. These tanks are beyond their life expectancy. Over three periods in the last 40 years, work was done to extend the life expectancy of these tanks, and we're at the end of it now. So I'm asking the Department of Health, on behalf of the state, to please renegotiate this AOC to require the tanks to be replaced or upgraded to modern standards. And there is nothing, for people who are worried about the fact that we're going to be standing still, there is nothing that would prevent the Navy from being a good neighbor to start to implement immediately the groundwater monitoring and testing work that needs to be done.
That's right.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
I'm sorry, I forgot one last comment, but when we're talking about the cost analysis and the feasibility studies, the only thing that's mentioned in the AOC is the cost to the Navy of replacement. I'm also asking that the State Department of Health and EPA require the Navy and itself to do a cost analysis of what's the cost to the taxpayers of the world